Hello, welcome to Mumbai, India. Thank you for joining me here. I'm just going to move around a little bit. I am in front of Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus, otherwise known as CST, and it used to be called Victoria Terminus, the busiest train station in the world. Spokane, Washington. Hello. Give me a shout out where you are. I'm sorry, I'm reading through a cracked iPhone 6 Plus glass screen here that I dropped last week or this past week in Kathmandu. So I'm just doing my best. If I miss your comment, I apologize. Hello, Los Angeles, South Mississippi. How y'all doing down there? You are transported right now to Mumbai, India, outside of CST, Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus. It used to be called Victoria Terminus. It is an absolutely stunning building, Gothic architecture, Gothic English architecture. Hello, Australia, mixed with Indian, Asian influence. It is absolutely stunning. And it's massive, I have to tell you. It's absolutely massive. There are buildings all around this part of town called Fort. And I'll just show you from the other side of the street all of the gorgeous buildings that were built here in a lot of them in the 1800s, and they're still standing today. And no, you're absolutely right, but I'll tell you, I've spoken with many Indians who you know, they appreciate what the British left behind. I mean, the British built an incredible rail system here that still operates today. So they're grateful for some of these things, some of the infrastructure. But of course, they're happy to have their own country. Yeah, these are some of the taxis. They've converted a lot of the older ones to newer style. They're probably a lot more efficient fuel-wise. And the black and yellow ones are non-AC. The blue ones are AC, and they're actually pretty reasonable to take. I took one yesterday from around this part of town back to Colaba. It was about maybe a 12 minute taxi ride. It cost me about 60 cents, so I was pretty happy with that. I'm going to take a walk down here. I was inside the, I'll just show you how busy it is. It's a Sunday afternoon, and this is, I believe, the world's busiest train station. And I can't go inside and show you. I was actually, yesterday I was inside the terminus, and I was doing some filming, and a couple of nice Mumbai policemen came up to me very nicely, asked me to stop doing that. Oh, very cool. That's a good story about Hong Kong. They kindly asked me to stop. I'm not allowed to do that. So I was very apologetic, and they were very nice. Fire trucks and ambulances. Yes, absolutely. I know. I just saw a fire truck going somewhere yesterday. So yes, they absolutely have ambulances and fire trucks here. You can hear the inside the announcements inside the station. So I'm not allowed to take any video inside, but there's some openings down this way, so I can take some video outside, and maybe you can have a peek inside of the trains coming and going and the people getting off. But this is obviously a very busy part of town, and it's a Sunday afternoon. Well, I'll tell you, it's just really cool being here. I watched a lot of film on this station before I came, a lot of BBC documentaries. It does not smell bad around here, no. I know there's stories about India smells bad here. Yeah, there's, of course there's parts where it smells bad, but you know, it's like that everywhere. But right here, it doesn't smell bad. But you know, there's lots of pollution here, so you're gonna feel it in the air for sure. It's a big city, there's 18 million people that live here. So lots of vehicles, lots of emissions. So yes, naturally, there's gonna be some pollution here. People are absolutely incredibly friendly here. It's one of the reasons why I like India so much. People are super hospitable, and it's a different kind of hospitality. It's more like you're like their family. So it's people are very friendly here. You're going to get bad people everywhere, and yes, there are bad people, and some of them can bother tourists, but there's a lot of really good people here. So that's one of the trains right now inside. And this one doesn't seem to be moving, but they are extremely crowded. They have a saying for it, and I've just it's slipping my tongue right now for the rush hour, but it's like a super extreme crush or something like that, they call it, when people are just absolutely jam-packed on, and there's people that ride on the roof. But in the middle of the day, it's not so bad. The rush hour is the worst time, obviously, to be taking trains here. And it, like I said, it's absolutely massive, and there are many platforms inside. I have no idea what the unemployment rate is like here. I mean, I'm just assuming it's high. There's definitely a pretty big disparity between the rich and the poor, but there's also in India a very strong middle class emerging as part of the emerging economy. And So, thank you for that. train rides are really cheap. Yes, train rides are cheap. And there's another look inside the station. And I'm just going to take a quick walk back the other way. Thank you so much. And by all means, you can share the broadcast. Just swipe your screen left to right on iOS or up and down on Android, or tap the number. 1888, I believe it was completed. It took 10 years. They started it in 1878. So I do my research, thank you. Thank you so much, thanks for sharing. And I believe it's one of the most grandest train stations in all of India. I've been through in a few, just after the US Civil War, yeah. And I'm going to be in Mumbai at least for the next week, so you feel free to follow me. I'll be popping in here and there. I'm so happy I have an unlimited data plan here, so it'll be really easy to pop in on Periscope. I've just been exploring. This is my first time to Mumbai. I've just been exploring this area of town. It's called Fort. And a lot of old structures, you're welcome, left over from, of course, the British Raj. And a lot of change here, a lot of updating of neighborhoods that were once, thank you so much. A lot of updating of neighborhoods that were once, you know, cotton factories, converting into art galleries, nice restaurants. I just came from an area of town that has all kinds of art galleries, nice restaurants, and it certainly shows you the wealth that is in this city. And this is the most expensive city in India. And if you want to come and stay here, you're going to find the hotel rooms are on average a lot more than in most other Indian cities. And you're not going to get as much for your money as you might in a place like Jaipur or even Kolkata. You know, it certainly can be because, you know, of so many things going on. Life is all in front of you. I mean, you know, at the Taj Mahal Palace, you know, one of probably the most expensive hotels in India, there's people sleeping on the street right below. So, and there's begging everywhere, lots of people. But, you know, I mean, just walking around today on a Sunday afternoon, there's lots of quiet spaces in this city of 18 million people, I have to tell you. Yeah, absolutely, it can be overwhelming, but it also can be very stimulating. It's not for everybody, but it is one of the most unique travel experiences that you'll ever have if you come here. I do always say, though, if people are unsure about India, go to Nepal first. And if you like Nepal, just dial that up 10 times, and that's India. The food here is amazing. My first night, I had some fish tikka that was just to die for. I had a really nice fish curry last night that was cheaper than my special coffee at Starbucks. Good and bad things. And like I said, it's all in front of you here, but this is the main building of CST. And it is a World Heritage Site, UNESCO World Heritage Site. There's a sign right there, not too spicy. And it looks like they're doing some slight renovations here. There's some scaffolding up on some of the building. And there is the time, 2:20 in the afternoon in Mumbai, India. And more of this neighborhood. Very inexpensive. What are you referring to? food. Yeah, food is food in Mumbai. It can be very inexpensive and it can be very expensive. There's some very high-end restaurants here, and there's also, I mean, I paid. I'll tell you, my dinner last night was less than $5, and for a really nice fish curry dinner. I was just going to say, if somebody had asked earlier about if the Indian people are friendly, you can just see when they see me, they're waving and smiling. So yes, the people are very friendly here and curious. Yeah, it is cloudy today. It was sunny earlier, and then it's clouded over a little bit. It did this yesterday too, and then we got a little bit of rain at night, and I noticed there was maybe only... I'm a travel writer and a broadcaster. My main focus right now is podcasting, so I do a video podcast that's on iTunes called Far East Adventure Travel. And I'm looking at expanding that at the moment as well. So I'm here to write, document, film. I'm a photographer, photograph, and that's what I'm doing here right now. So after Mumbai, I'll probably move on to Kerala, because I haven't been to Kerala before. But this is my third visit to India in the last 3 years. So the podcast is on iTunes. It's called Far East Adventure Travel, or you can go to my website, fareastadventuretravel.com. So I'll join you again from somewhere around, come to Kolkata. You know, that was the last time I was in India was late 2013, and that's where I was. I was in West Bengal, I was in Darjeeling and Kolkata. I have a friend that lives in Kolkata. And you know, I had a great time in Kolkata. I got sick though. It was the very first time I ever got sick in India. I really did enjoy Kolkata, and it's a different cuisine, different than Mumbai for sure. I do like Kolkata, and I will return to. In Mumbai, either later today or tomorrow. It's. An absolutely interesting place. I've just barely scratched the surface. So I will talk to you again. Thank you so much for joining me here. It's John Sabo, Far East Adventure Travel, Mumbai, India. Thank you, Chicago. Thank you, everyone.